Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16 has a bunch of features, changes, and updates in it that I covered in an initial What's New video, but there's over 50 more that I wanted to share with you today. The first thing has to do with game controllers. Up to this point, we could use PS5, Xbox controllers, and more. Now with iOS 16, you can use Nintendo Joy-Con and the Pro Controller as well. The next thing is under software updates. If we go under Settings, General, and Software Update, tap on Automatic Updates, you'll see Install System and Data Files. This is a new feature option where you can update to the latest version of iOS, where it could include automatic updates to security configurations and system data files. Some updates may only take effect once you restart your phone, so this is a new option in Software Updates. Under the Home app, there's also a new update option you saw just disappear, but if you have the updates for maybe an HomePod set up, it will actually show that there's an update available. When you unlock your phone, you can now unlock it in landscape on an iPhone 13 model. This is only available on the iPhone 13 series devices for some reason. Also, if you're unlocking your phone with a Face ID phone and it's a ways away, it will actually give you a message that says Face is too far away. Also on the lock screen, if you have a timer set, you'll see one of the new live activities. You can interact with the notification and you'll see many more of these in the future. If you're creating a new lock screen with a new photo, you can have it shuffle through photos. Tap on Photo Shuffle, select if you want people, nature, urban, or more, and then change the shuffle frequency. You can go from on tap, on wake, hourly, or daily, and then use the featured photo and change it throughout your day. Also on the lock screen, you'll have live activities for music where you can interact with it. And also you'll see here that we have the matching AirPods if you have AirPods connected. Tap on them and they'll show your different options, but the AirPods will match whether that be AirPods 3, Pro, Max, or something else. Also, if we go in the control center, we have the matching icon in the music widget. So tap on that, you get the same sort of thing, and that's new as well. Also in the control center, we have a new option for Quick Note. Tap on Quick Note and we can make a quick note just like we could in iOS 15, but on iPad. So that's new to iOS 16, and you can add that under the Control Center options in your settings. Just scroll down and you'll see Quick Note under More Controls. Also within the Control Center, if an app recently used your location or information, you can see it at the top, tap on it, and it will say what it used under Privacy, Location, and Recently. So if an app is using that, it will give you a rundown of what recently used that, whether it be your microphone, your camera, and more. On the home screen, we have a new search button that gets you into Spotlight search. You can just pull down and do the same thing like you always could, or you can tap the button. If you don't want the button there and you prefer the dots, as when you're moving your screens back and forth, you can go to Settings, go to Home or Home Screen, and turn off Show Spotlight. That will disable it from saying search. Within Settings, under Wi-Fi, you'll see that we have our typical networks. However, if we tap on Edit, now you can see your known networks. So here's all of the known networks listed, and maybe if I go to the I under that network, we now have the option to copy and paste our password and tap on it and then see the password. Under your iCloud settings, you can see system storage at the top. The colors are a little bit different and it's arranged differently and gives more information with iOS 16 on the right. Also, you can see that the menu is completely different and sort of separated into different categories. At the bottom, you have device backups. If we go to device backups, you can backup now and see all of your device backups, where before you had to go through multiple settings under manage storage to see your device backups. If we copy some text or a link from a third-party app and then go and paste it in another third-party app, we'll actually get a message asking us if we want to paste that the first time we try it. So that's just a new security notification that lets us know that you're pasting from one app to the other, and it blocks that if you don't want that. Within a video, you'll see that it's finding live text. Tap on the little live text option and it will show you where there's live text, where it actually says navigate here in my car. Also within live text, you'll see my video from the other day, every feature that doesn't work on older phones. Tap on the live text option and this time it recognizes the temperature on the iPhone in the video. Press the little temperature icon and then we can convert it to Celsius, Fahrenheit, or degrees. Tap on Convert Celsius and you'll see it shows Celsius. You can copy that. It may not be 100% accurate. And then we can also convert degrees, such as degrees, radians, turns, or percent grades. Then we can copy and paste that elsewhere. Now that also goes along with the new video player. So you'll see the video player here, where it's a little bit different than what we had on iOS 15 below. So the video player has changed quite a bit. The play button's in the middle. We have 10 seconds on either side of it, as opposed to at the bottom with a long bar to scrub through the different footage. So the bar, you can still scrub through. And then of course you have your share options in the bottom right, for playback speed, languages, and subtitles. Now you can also swipe to go those 10 seconds ahead. So maybe you're playing the video. Let me turn it down here. We'll hit play. To go ahead, you can just swipe 10 seconds ahead by swiping to the right, or swipe back 10 seconds by swiping to the left. Now, to go along with the live text and video, you can also translate from a photo. So just maybe move in the iPad here and then go to that photo. Within that photo, we can now translate in real time. So you'll see again, it shows the different degrees. And then maybe if we press and hold on the words here, we can convert those or look at the word itself, maybe this one here, and then translate it. So we can translate directly from the app. You'll see it says reminders, and then we can translate it to a different language of our choice. So change the language, and we have all of these different options, everything from Spanish to Korean to German to English, Chinese, and so on. So we can change it, and it will show us in real time what it is and how to say it. Apple's new notifications show up at the bottom on the lock screen and your notification shade. But if you go into settings, go to notifications, you now have an option to display as. You can display as account, stack, or list. So if we change it to stack, we'll pull down notifications. It doesn't seem to do a whole lot at this point, maybe because it's beta 1, but you do have options to show different options for your lock screen. So that's something a little bit new that we'll probably see change in the future. Within messages, there's even more options than just editing your texts. Go into messages. When you delete a thread, slide over, hit delete. At the bottom, it says this conversation will be deleted from all your devices. Tap on delete. And if you go back to your messages, just swipe back to the last option, you now have the option for recently deleted. Go into recently deleted. After you've deleted a conversation, it says conversations show the days remaining before deletion. After that time, messages will be permanently deleted. This may take up to 40 days. And you'll see the amount of days left on the right here, where it says 30 days, 30 days, 25, and 25 days. Tap on the conversation, and you can recover it or delete it immediately. Within a message, if you tap on the message option to actually record a voice message, tap and record, and after you've recorded that message, you stop and send that message, you now have the option while it's playing to scrub through it. So now you can play it back and scrub through the message just by dragging your finger. So that will allow you to listen to any part of the message where you couldn't do that before. Within photos, if you tap on the options in the upper right, the three dots, you'll see we have the aspect ratio grid. Tap on this and we'll see the actual aspect ratio that the photos were taken in, whether that be 16:9 or vertical or something else. So if they're square, they'll show square, but we can change that back either way. Also, if we go in here, we can now filter, and under filter, we now have the option to exclude shared with you. So if you don't want any of the things shared with you through messages or other places, you can remove those from your photo library and they won't show up there. That wasn't available until iOS 16. If you're in a photo, tap on edit, and maybe you want to make an adjustment. So we'll change the exposure here, brighten it a little bit, and maybe we'll change the brilliance a little bit. And we now have the option to undo or redo. So you want to see before and after, we can easily do that now right in the Photos app where we couldn't before. Also, maybe you're cropping the photo and you want it to fit an iPhone because you want to use it as a wallpaper. So we can go into our options here in the upper right, and down at the bottom, we have the option for wallpaper, and we have the option for vertical or horizontal, you'll see here, and we can change it so that it looks proper on a phone. In photos under search, we can now search for individual words. And so I searched for the word apple. You'll see it found 1,003 examples of not only the word apple, but also things that include Apple products. So you'll see here, if we scroll down maybe to the iOS 15.0.2 install, when that came out a long time ago, it shows you where it found the word apple within that photo. So that's been updated. Then also within live text, you can now select all of the text at once. So you can select whatever you'd like as it identifies it, open links, of course, but maybe we want to select part of this or select all. We have the option to select all text now. Then we can go to the options in the upper right, copy, duplicate that, or change it to maybe add it to an album, revert to original, and so on. Siri has a new announce notifications option under accessibility. Go to your options under accessibility, scroll down to Siri, scroll to the bottom, and it now announces notifications on speaker. So if you turn this option on, it says Siri announces your notifications to you over your device's speaker. Under your widgets, there's a new sleep widget. So we had this version before where we had time in bed and it showed a vertical graph. Now if we go to the second option, we now have a horizontal graph showing our time in bed. Speaking of sleep, within the health options, you'll see show more sleep data. And this is the first time I've been able to see this, as I don't typically use this to measure my sleep, but you'll see amounts, stages, and then comparisons, and it will measure all of this information if you're wearing your watch or have a compatible device. So you have stages, which show awake, your REM sleep, core, and deep sleep. You'll see under iOS 15, you don't have those options. Within the health app, under browse and then body measurements, at the bottom, we have vision prescriptions. Under vision prescriptions, we can now add a prescription for glasses we're wearing or something else. So everything from your right sphere, right axis, left axis, right pupillary distance, and so on. Within music, under artists, there's a new option to favorite the artist. Then you can add notifications and more. The first time you go into an artist page, it will give you a little pop-up as well, telling you that you can favorite it now. Also, when you're playing a song, you'll see the sliders look a little different to scrub through the different music itself and then also the volume slider. There's no longer a ball on either of them. Within a playlist, tap on the three buttons in the upper right and you now have new sort by options: playlist order, title, artist, album, and release date. Podcast gets an update where the play scrubber here is below the title and now the menu with the three dots is to the right of the title. So you have all of the options here to share and more. Also, the sleep options are now in the bottom right. So we have the option to set sleep in 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour, and when current episode ends. Before, you actually had to scroll down and tap on sleep timer. Also, the option to play faster is now changed, where you can change the play speed to 1x, 1.25x, 1.5x, and so on. And it's now a list instead of just tapping to repeat the versions that you wanted. So they finally made that a little bit easier to change. The contacts app is updated, and within contacts, you'll see it now finds duplicates. So we can go in and then merge those or delete those. Also, if we go back one menu, you'll see that we have lists for all contacts, iCloud, and iPhone now. And also, if we go into a contact, go down to share contact, we now have a new option to filter fields. Tap on filter fields, and we can exclude anything from our contact that we don't want to share. So whether that be the name, the address, or the number, we can deselect all fields or select some of them and then just share those. Within settings, if we go to accessibility, scroll down to touch. Under touch, scroll down toward the bottom, we now have the option to lock to end call. It says press the side button to end the current call. It's a new option that's found within accessibility. And then there's also a new option in your phone settings. If you're using an eSIM, you can now transfer that eSIM to another device by tapping a button. Of course, if you have a physical SIM like I do, you'll have to eject the SIM and then physically put it in a different device. Also, if you're in an area that has no cellular connectivity, currently it will show SOS. So you'll have SOS in the top instead of your different bars showing your cellular connectivity data. If you're charging your phone, whether that be wirelessly or with lightning, it will actually tell you that it's stopped charging if it's become too hot. So if the phone gets really hot when charging, whether that be you're using a case, it's just outside and warm, it will tell you that it put it on hold to allow it time to cool and then it resumed charging. So before it would do that by itself, now it's just giving you a message about it. On iPad, within the new weather app, I've shown some of this before on iOS. Of course, you have the same sort of granular control that you can go into each thing you want to look at, such as temperature, and you can change this too based on what you want to see. So there's a drop down here now that shows UV index, wind, precipitation, feels like, humidity, visibility, and pressure. So we get all of the same things on the iPad, but also we have a sidebar. Tap on the sidebar and you can see all of the different locations. So it's giving a little alert to stay dry and enable notifications, and you can see all of the different locations here on the sidebar. So if you want to keep that visible and just switch between different locations, you can do that. Within the Notes app, if you want to scribble a message, you'll see it says this note is sideways. Tap on it, select all. It recognizes the text just like before. Tap on it again, and we have some options at the top. scroll to the end of the options, and we can now straighten the text. So it automatically straightens the text wherever we want, and then we can move it around. Now we can see it properly. So that's 50 additional changes and features that weren't mentioned in the initial What's New video, and there's probably even more we haven't found. So I'll be sure to cover that, and we're looking forward to beta 2, where we'll probably see some additional features and updates as well. If you've found anything I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, and of course I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.